हेलो स्टूडेंट्स,
लेट्स कंटिन्यू विद द प्रीवियस टॉपिक. व्हाट वी हैव स्टार्टेड डिसीजन थ्योरी, दैट इज यूनिट नंबर 4. इन दिस यूनिट वी वर डिस्कसिंग डिसीजन मेकिंग एनवायरनमेंट्स. देर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ एनवायरनमेंट. द फर्स्ट वन इज डिसीजन मेकिंग अंडर सर्टेनिटी, सेकेंड डिसीजन मेकिंग अंडर अनसर्टेनिटी, एंड द थर्ड वन इज डिसीजन मेकिंग अंडर रिस्क. ऑल राइट, सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग decision making under uncertainty. In this method there are five criteria, like as first one is optimistic criteria, pessimistic criteria, regret criteria, Hurwitz criteria and Laplace criteria. Up to three criteria we have already done. Hope you all are understanding. Let's continue with the fourth criteria, that is Hurwitz criteria. Hurwitz criteria, this is also known as criteria of realism. All right, it is also known as weighted average criteria. This criteria is based on Hurwitz concept of coefficient of optimism or pessimism. It is a compromise between criteria of optimism, that is maximax, and the criteria of pessimism, that is maximin. In this criteria, the decision maker make a balance between the maximum and minimum for each alternative by weighting them according to his degree of optimism and pessimism. Right. So in this method, there are following steps which we will discuss in the next slide. Step number first, choose an appropriate degree or optimism or pessimism. If A, a constant lying between 0 and 1, denotes the degree of optimism, then the degree of pessimism will be 1 minus A. Step number 2, determine the maximum as well as minimum payoff for each alternative. Step number 3, determine the quantities capital H for each alternative such that H is equal to A, that is alpha multiply maximum plus 1 minus alpha into minimum payoff for each alternative. Step number 4, select the alternative corresponding to maximum value of capital H in payoff, that is your profit table, or minimum value of capital H in cost or loss table. The fifth one method is Laplace criteria under the method or the environment of uncertainty. Right. This criteria is based on the principle of equal likelihood or insufficient reason. Here all the outcomes, that is events, should be considered equally likely. If there are n events, that is states of nature, each can be assigned a probability of occurrence equal to 1 upon n. Using these probabilities, we calculate the expected payoff for each course of action, and the action with maximum expected value is regarded as the optimal decision. In this criteria, the stepwise processor is as follows. The steps are, step number first, assign equal probability 1 upon n to each event if there are n events. Step number 2, determine the expected payoff, that is profit value, for each alternative. Expected payoff value for an alternative is equal to sum of the products of probabilities and the corresponding payoffs for that alternative. Step number 3, select the alternative corresponding to maximum expected payoff profit in payoff table. Right. When you do the practice of numerical, when you solve the numerical, then you will be more clear in comparison to this. Right. In the next video lecture, we will solve one more numerical basically related to all these five criteria. Right. So in the next video lecture, I will cover all these five methods to solve the numerical. Right. Till the time, you go through all these. Right. And in the next video lecture, we will continue with the second method, that is decision making under risk. All right. Thank you so much. Bye bye, class.